everyone. Let's begin with the Scramble for Africa. What is it exactly? Well, in the 19th century, 1885, the Scramble for Africa began. Countries taking over parts of Africa, colonizing the lands, and stripping away the natural resources it had to offer. People were being enslaved every day to gather these resources, and if they were to fail to do so, they would then have to face a tremendous punishment, mostly leading to amputation and often death. Now, with most of Africa being taken over, let's take our focus towards Mali. Mali is a country located within the interior of Western Africa, southwest of Algeria, and north of Guinea. This country was colonized by the French colonial rule in 1892, and the reason why the French had chosen Mali was because it had proven to be a strategic location since its location is along the Niger River, as well as its abundance and rich natural resources. During this time, the French colonial authorities had sought to exploit these resources through the establishment of agricultural plantations, mining operations, and forced labor. Later in 1893, the French had appointed a civilian governor of territory, the Soudan Francais, translating into French Sudan. However, an act of resistance towards French rule continued. By 1905, already most of Mali had fallen under the control of the French, and in 1915, a large anti-French uprising broke out among the tribes in the regions of the present day, this being Mali and Burkina Faso. A year later, the last resistance the French had to fight was in 1916. However, during this suppression, over 100 villages were destroyed by the French colonial troops. Many lost their homes and families that year. In 1958, the newly renamed Sudanese Republic had obtained a complete internal autonomy, the act of independence, and the freedom of the will of one's actions, and furthermore, they had joined the French community in 1958. And finally, leading up to June 20th, 1960, the Federation of Mali had become an independent country along with Modibo Keita to become the very first president in the history of Mali, ruling from 1960 until 1968. Fun fact, did you know that the two countries that won the most during the Scramble for Africa were both Britain and France, both being considered the two greatest victors in the terms of existing colonies? This was mainly because of their advantage in military power and overall weaponry, thus making it easier to colonize countries with few of these technologies. Some social impacts that lasted in Mali due to imperialism would be their change in languages, this being their transition into the French language. This has impacted their local languages and cultures, thus leading to the gradual decline in the use of indigenous language in formal settings and towards the younger generations. This linguistic divide has also influenced the social mobility and the governance in Mali. Now, the economic impacts of Mali are the governance structures both during and after colonialism have struggled with corruption, efficiency, and the challenge of creating a diversified economy. These issues are partly rooted from the colonial administrative practices that prioritize control and extraction over the development and public service. Also under the French rule, Mali's agricultural sector was reoriented towards the production of cash crops for the exportation, and as this legacy continued, it had affected the food security as well as the economic stability of the rural households. Furthermore, with Mali's heavy reliance on cotton, it has also made them more susceptible to fluctuations in the global commodity prices, this then affecting the farmers' income and the national economy as a whole. Finally, some of Mali's environmental impacts can be the extensive environmental degradation of the land, this otherwise being known as deforestation, and during this time the locals were forced to cut down these forests in order to market them. Another impact is the loss of minerals and gemstones, as well as the natural resources such as rubber and cotton being the most popular, from the land, and with this had caused significant environmental damage such as biodiversity loss. With these negative impacts that lasted in Mali, you would expect to have no positive impacts. Well, that is where you would be wrong. During the French colonization, there had been humanitarian efforts in some colonies in order to improve on the sanitation, hospitals, and schools for communities. And with this, the people of Mali's lifespans had increased, as well as their literacy. This has also led to economic expansion, and additionally, it had also provided more products and desired goods towards Mali, such as railroads for transportation and the telegraph for communication. However, nonetheless, with these improvements, Mali still remains one of the poorest countries in the world, and the way that you can help support them can be by contributing towards various donations towards their country to help them live in a better world. And thus, this concludes the entire history and the impacts and advantages that Mali had received from imperialism. Thank you.